you right now, Lord God. I come before you right now, emptying out all the shields so that you may be full, God. That you may bring a word to your people, Lord God, that may change their life, Lord God. So God, I thank you right now, God. And I pray that you would have your way, God. And we'll always, forever give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. It is in Jesus' name I pray. I have my thirst.
All right.
Hallelujah. And I went through over and over again trying to think about my thirst. I researched everything, looked at everything, and it was just a common, I thirst.
Uh-huh.
And so I told him, you know, I got to thinking, I kept on going, they have to think, I thirst, he thirsts. But then God began to show me something.
Well,
and I thank him for showing me.
Amen.
He said, I thirst. Why did Jesus say it? He said it so the scriptures may be fulfilled.
Yeah.
But what he began to show me was Jesus' love and his obedience for his Father was not wavering. He didn't waver whatever his Father wanted. He did. Even though there were times he didn't want to go through it, he even asked his Father, if there be any other way that you can remove this cup from me.
Yeah.
But Father, yet your will be done, and not my will. And I think about that, and I think about his suffering. And I think about how the one of the most things that probably made that hurt him the most is when he had to separate himself from his Father. And I said, wow, that's really painful. So I began to think about thirst again. And I thought, when I thought about thirst, I said, he's crying out for some compassion. So for some compassion. So I looked up the word compassion. And it said, really the act of going out of your way to help physical, spiritual, or emotional hurts or pains of another. That's everything Jesus was doing.
Amen.
He was on that cross, hands stretched out. Hallelujah. He was beaten on Sunday, on Palm Sunday, they was praising him. And then within a few days, they turned it back on him. How many of us have experienced that? Well, everybody say, I'm with you, I got you, I got you. But when the fire get hot, they go. So I give God thanks. But the most important thing that I realized from this, that the obedience that Christ had for his Father and the love that God had for his Son, God said, I love my people so much, I'm going to give them my best. And John 16 said he gave his very best. He gave his Son, Jesus. And then Jesus said, okay, Daddy, I'm going to give my life. And I thought about that. I said, God, that's an awesome thing. That is so awesome. And then I got to thinking some more, and I got excited. I said, this is about a relationship about love and obedience, but we're reaping the benefits. We're reaping the benefits because he stayed on that cross for us, that we may have redemption, and that we may experience some living water, which is the Holy Spirit that never dries up. And I say, God, I thank you. I thank you so much because you didn't have to do it. And I said, God, I thank you. And then a question came to me. I said, what are you thirsting for?
Yeah.
Jesus was on that cross for us. God gave his Son for us.
Yeah.
These are examples. He gave examples of what he needs and what he wants from us. He said, what are you thirsting for? Are you thirsty enough to go into the desolate places? Are you thirsty enough to lift that sister that's down on the ground? Are you thirsty enough to make a change in this world? What are you thirsting for?
Yeah.
thirsting for. To God be all the glory.